told us about this art teacher with a wacky idea that set up their own sort of resources for art. So what made you realise that this could work for every subject?
Well, of course, every teacher in a school has similar problems. They've got 30 children, they're one teacher. The differentiation problem, you know, it's a perennial problem. It's a problem that every teacher totally understands because it's terrifying. 30 kids all needing you and one of you. So it's really, really difficult. So I knew that that was there, and I thought, well, okay, if the potential's there in a creative subject, I think actually, because a creative subject doesn't have a syllabus. It has a syllabus, but it doesn't have like a student guide that you can go to. It's very much an individual pursuit. So actually, theoretically, it should be easier for something with a textbook. You should be able to do it easier. It's certainly easier to create resources and put them in order. So I thought that was, I always knew that there was the potential, but actually in practice what happened was that a few of my friends in other departments saw what I was doing. And they thought, hang on a minute, your results are in the bin. Yeah? And my results were always higher than the art department. How has that changed? And so they wanted a piece of the action. So they said to me, well, okay, how are you doing it? What are you doing? So I just shared my good practice, mm-hmm. and then made it easier for them because I had a little bit of technical knowledge then.
Perfect. So in terms of this school, it was very easy for me to join this school. It was established and it existed 21 years ago, 22 years ago when you were setting this up. Did everyone think you were crazy?
Everyone did think I was crazy. I actually thought I was crazy to some extent, but you know, it's a really weird thing because I don't actually take a lot of credit for the kinds of things that happened. For me, it's almost like I'm a vessel. I don't want to get too philosophical, but it actually feels like I'm a vessel and that somebody's using me like some kind of puppet to make these things happen. Because I actually don't know how we got here. It's just a remarkable thing. And I think if there's any quality that I've got, it's merely that I just want the best for the kids. And I know a lot of teachers do. But I've also got these other skill sets in terms of the technology piece and the creativity piece, and actually just a determination to not just settle for what we've already got, and the idea that actually there's always a better way. We've just got to keep striving and pushing for it. So yeah, they thought I was crazy for sure, you know, no doubt.
So in today's market, we're the longest established online school, Cambridge Homeschool. There's lots of schools popping up now. It's the market for online schools growing vastly. Yeah. What makes a Cambridge homeschool different? What makes it unique? What makes it the best online school?
Well, I'd start by saying it's a school, actually. That's the simple answer. It didn't take very long to get there, like some of the other answers. It's a school, it's a school because it has a community. It's a school because it has a life of its own. It's a school because people want to be there. It's a school because, you know, it does more than just help people to get grades. It helps them become well-rounded people. It helps them be the best versions of themselves, someone once said. So it's a unique place. It also allows the students are from everywhere. You know, so you can be in a classroom and you can have children, you know, from any continent, from any country, and you'll be sitting there live with people from different cultures, and it's different from the multicultural classroom that you see in the UK, which is a kind of anglicised sort of bleached version of multiculturalism. So you know, if you've got second generation Indian person sitting in the classroom, you know, of course they're Indian heritage, but they've grown up in Hackney, you know, so they're as much Hackney as they are Indian, whereas in our school, you know, they're in Delhi, they're still Indian, there's no bleaching, there's no change. So you really do get a massive insight into what life is like in Delhi. So if there's an earthquake in Turkey, you know, children will see the rumbling on the camera, you know, as harrowing as that might be, but they don't have to read about it in the news. They actually are part of the news, you know. So it's really, really unique. And of course, the teachers are amazing. We can get teachers from any part of the globe. So what that means is that we won't struggle in getting master's qualified, PhD qualified teachers, whereas any other school, and I mean Eton, you know, Harrow, all of the top schools, those guys, they're reliant upon teachers who are one car journey away. And there's only so many people with a PhD one car journey away from any school, whereas for us, we can go global. We can get whoever we want. And it means that those teachers can teach you know, as part of a semi-retirement model. You know, so they're giving back and they want to be there. They're not burnt out, and so the teacher, so the kids are getting the huge advantage of having those really, really incredible quality subject leading teachers who want to be there. Everybody wants to be there. I think that makes that school really unique.
In doing a little bit of research, the majority of the students are British, but there's students from 54 countries in the school.
54, wow.
What does that do? How does that affect day-to-day school life? How does it affect the community?
Well, what it does, I think, is it helps to solve some of the bigger problems in society, because it's no stranger to anybody that there are lots of divisions, and there are lots of politicians in the world who are sowing division. You know, there's Donald Trump there, you know, half of America is turned against the other half of America, and that's how he's getting into power, or trying again to get into power. And we saw what happened there when he, you know, mobilised some really desperate and awful factions there. So we don't want to see that in the world. We as educators want to educate by exposure to reality rather than fake news. And I think having schools on the model of our school, what it does is it brings people literally together. You know, in a classroom where you've got people from all different continents, those, that generation who grows up in a school like that with that kind of education, they're not going to buy the Trump narrative. You know, they're not going to go with the Nigel Farage narrative, you know, the division piece, you know, it's them versus us and all of that. They can see that actually they're great people from all different cultures, and they might have different practices and different ways of living their lives and following different religions, but they're all great people. And they're all, and that's the wonderful thing about Cambridge Homeschool Online, is that it's the community, the way that people are being drawn together to support each other. You know, the lift me up analogy was used, wasn't it, by one of the students. So, and that is unique. And the way the school is that we've got young kids, you know, participating in activities that would normally be reserved for older kids. So we have this vertical family, which is beautiful, where everybody's looking after each other, looking out for each other, and the older ones are taking on kind of leadership roles, trying to nurture the younger ones, and the younger ones are striving to be follow those role models, and it's just a snowball effect. It's beautiful, really beautiful to see.
We all know the value of education. It's probably the most important thing that any child can have. Mm. Who does the school work for? What type of families? What is this the right school for?
That's a really excellent question, actually. Well, you know, it's been a journey since 2002, and a lot of the children that would come to online education, it's fair to say, were children that were struggling in conventional schools, maybe for special educational needs, disability, anxiety, that kind of thing. But actually, since the pandemic, and perhaps a little bit before the pandemic, you've got a different situation now. Most people have been exposed, most families have been exposed to online learning. It's not a thing anymore. We don't get asked the question, what is online learning? We don't get asked, what is an online school? It's self-evident. What's also self-evident is that the families that are coming to us now are those families who saw a transformation in their child during the pandemic. So it's a very common, we ask for a personal statement from the children, and you get a really legitimate and genuine feedback really from the children on why they want to do online school, and what it was like in the pandemic potentially, and what it's like in their current school. And what you're getting is a dissatisfaction with current school setup, even in very well-known private fee-paying schools. There's a big dissatisfaction because a lot of children actually just want to learn. They want to learn, and if they're really motivated to get to a top university, they don't want to put up. They might find it funny occasionally, you know, to have the classroom clown, you know, doing their daily performance, you know, a lesson by lesson performance. But there comes a point where it gets old. You know, it can get old quite quickly for motivated learners. So you ask the question, who are the people? They're motivated. They're really motivated people. They want to be there. They have a vision of what the future could be. They want to be the best versions of themselves. They want to be able to get their top grades. They don't want to settle and just sit back and hope life works out. They've had a taste of it during the pandemic when they had online lessons. And they've realised that the huge increase in pace. They can work so much faster without all of those distractions, with the recorded lessons, with the brilliant teacher, with the small classes, you know, with the community, you know, with the extracurricular clubs. you know, they can make such big progress. And if you look at the reviews, the video reviews, which have been given very graciously by the parents, they talk about this transformation in their child. You know, I can't believe how much more mature they are, how much more independent they are. Where's all that frustration? Where's that silly persona that they put on that said, oh, I don't care, the Kevin and Perry persona? You know, that's not there. They just go back. And actually, one of the key lines is, I got my daughter back. I got my son back. You know, they joined your school and I got my daughter back. They like me again. You know, it's fantastic.
Students will be able to develop social skills at Cambridge Homeschool Online?
We use Microsoft Teams for Education, which is a really fantastic platform. It allows people to talk to each other in small groups. They can talk to each other in the live lessons, and they can also create little groups for themselves and talk within those groups as well. So, yeah, there's no doubt in my mind, if you ask our students, they make friends online. And actually, that is the generation that we've got here now, isn't it? They all have friends online. Everybody, every young person has friends online.
Brilliant. And final question. What's next? What's the future for Cambridge Homeschool Online?
Well, it's going from strength to strength. There's more and more students joining. There's more and more parents investing in the idea of online school, and actually the dissatisfaction, which is huge in conventional education, is bubbling over. And so I'm really excited for the future. It's just going to be the same, but better and better and better as time goes on, with more and more people getting involved. Can't wait. It's fantastic.
Amazing. Thank you very much.
Thank you.